Hi, tango dancer. Do you, like us, love the tango walk? And are you always on the lookout for more interesting ways to add the tango walking into your dancing? If yes, then this video is for you. We are going to show you a really cool way to walk in cross system with a nice resolution.
Hi, this is Pablo Anand from Tango Space,
where we help men and women to move better, express themselves and dance elegantly with our tango lessons.
Yes, in this video we want to share with you a very nice sequence that starts in the cross system, but the interesting thing of this cross system is that we are going to go only on the outside of the follower. Yes, with the leaders we are going to walk only on the outside. It's very important to be very precise, otherwise it's not going to look good and you will start doing zigzag. That's why we need to focus, you will see, we need to focus and stay always in a straight line.
And you will see for the followers, it does require a lot of control and precision, so it's a really challenging and exciting movement for us too.
So now we show you the moment. Now we are going to break down the steps for the leaders. So we begin this with the apertura, side step, and I'm going to walk in cross system. So I change my weight and I don't change her weight. So I'm going to walk with my left leg outside of her for one step. Remember, leaders, here we need to keep the straight line. So what you want is to step exactly next to her foot. Yeah? So I go with my foot slow to find the space, and then when I can feel where is her foot, I'm going to land just next to her foot. One. And now I'm going to go outside on the other side. So again, I need to go with my foot to find the space and to land next to her foot. Two, three, another step outside now, but on the left side. Three steps, and now we do a small bagocho. And in the second bagocho, we are going to go into the medio giro, half giro. One, two, three, and we finish. So now we are going to do it one more time in this direction so you can see from another angle. So we go one outside on her right side, another step outside on her left side, another step on her right side, and then the ocho. And then in the second ocho, we go with her into the parallel system into the medio giro, and we finish.
For the followers, this movement does require some precision on our side. The first thing I'd like to invite you to do is to really understand what is happening when you are dancing and realize what is happening in terms of the tools that he's using. Here, he makes us go into cross system. We want you ladies to understand he's doing that so that you can adapt your walking, your technique, to the new movement. So here, we're doing a side step together. He changes his weight, but doesn't change our weight. We need to understand what is happening, because this tells us we are now in cross system, and as a consequence, ladies, we are going to share our tracks with him. So he's going to walk on one line here next to us. We are not going to walk on two tracks, we are going to walk on one track. So we need to walk behind ourselves. This is very important. Otherwise, we are going to lose the connection in the closing embrace. Here, behind, and then we walk behind ourselves, so on one track, and then again, we are still in the cross system, so on one track. This does not mean that we are pivoting and doing ochos. We stay very straight. And then here, we do an ocho. And so here, another element that is very important is that you need to pivot fully. He's inviting us to do a full pivot. So pivot 180 degrees. I pivot fully. Otherwise, if I don't pivot fully, if I finish my pivot here, I'm going to take a back step away from him, where in the contrary, I want to go towards him. So I pivot fully, take a back step, pivot again, and then back, side, forward, and then we finish in front of him.
Now we show you in the close embrace. As you could see, we were keeping the close embrace during the walk, of course, and in the small 8, we were tightening the embrace. Yes, I'm kind of lifting my center and lifting my arms to invite her to do this very small 8, otherwise she will do big 8, so we want to keep it tight with embrace in a way that she understands that it's a small 8 what you are leading. And then we are going to release a little bit more in the medio giro, yeah, when she's doing the pattern around your axis. And then we are going to resolve back in the close embrace to continue walking.
Followers, make sure that in the medio giro, in the half turn, you are really dissociating so that you are staying towards him with the center of your chest. So at the end, yes, when we do the medio giro, we go towards our partner, towards our partner, towards our partner as much as possible. Keep the center of the torso towards the leader's torso. So now we show you with tango music.
Mi vida tan serena condenaste hacia el dolor, nunca podré arrancar de mi pecho nunca el abrojito pulsante y ando por todo el mal que me has hecho con el alma agonizante.
The walk is really a fundamental movement of tango dancing, and whether it's cross system or parallel system, you want to practice your walk. Using it in cross system really adds a lot of sophistication and edginess to your dancing, and it allows you to play more with the music while keeping the linearity of the movement and moving forward on the dance floor.
Yes, and remember that, you know, the walk is something you want to make it more interesting and more elegant. Yes, and this is a nice way because it's different. Yes? What we are proposing here is that as a leader I walk only on the outside of the follower in cross system. And then we are going to resolve with a circular movement in parallel system. So it's a very nice way to add, you know, some spice into the walk and to make it more interesting and more creative.
For the followers, you really want to understand the cross system and understand what is happening here, so that whenever he's moving from parallel to cross system back into parallel system, you know what's happening and you are able to adapt your technique, your posture, your embrace, and not be a passive follower who is wondering what is happening, but instead an equal partner who is really working with your leader. So really important to understand what's happening here and here and practice it. Now, if this video was helpful, please like it, give it a thumbs up and share it with a tango friend that you love. If you are on YouTube and you want to learn more of your tango, learn faster, make your tango dancing feel and look more connected and more musical, make sure you are subscribed to the channel. We share weekly video tips that will help you be more connected, more musical, more creative in your dancing. Also, click on the notification bell That way you are notified every time we release a new video and you can make sure you're checking out everything that is helpful for you. And especially,
please keep learning and keep sharing your dancing because the world of tango in your embrace.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you so much for watching and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.
Bye.